Danny, must be a special feeling, your first win as head coach at Colchester United.
Yeah, just pleased for everybody associated with the club. The boys have been incredible all week. Their work ethic, their focus, been really impressed. And the staff as well, just brilliant, all going the extra yard. And of course, our brilliant supporters, maybe 6 hours plus to get here today. So just pleased for everyone associated with the club.
And everyone must be pleased in the changing room, but was that the feeling after 8 or so minutes? You must have thought it's going to be a long game if we play like that for the whole game.
No, the only part of the game that was disappointing was the start. I just didn't think that we stamped our authority on the game. And it's definitely something we can learn from that. But, yeah, no, for us, of course, it's an outstanding outcome, and we're so delighted that the outcome is good for us. But more importantly than that, it was the process and the performance. And I think, you know, we score a goal that is worthy of winning any game of football at any level. That's a fact. You know, I said on the bench as Arthur Reid went up to take it, I said, only Gazza scores from here. And he finds it, bends it into the top corner. And then Owen Goodman, for a really harshly given penalty, by the way, I knew he'd save it. I watched him in training. He moves so quickly across his goal line. And Yilmaz, our goalkeeper coach, is so well organised. So, you know, Mellon has been taking the penalties prior, but we had a feeling that Garner would take it, so we'd gone back and watched his previous clips, and we knew which way he would go. And yeah, so credit to Yilmaz and obviously to Owen, what a fantastic goalkeeper he is. Yeah,
and in that second half, once Owen had made that save, we had pretty much immediate control of the game after that. Just disappointed that we didn't extend the lead and make it a bit more comfortable towards the end?
Yeah, I think so. I think we probably took 7 or 8 minutes for us just to get any control in the game. I think Arthur Reid hits a tackle, and then we'd had a free kick early, and we just tossed it forward, and we don't want to do that. We want to dominate the ball in the attacking half. And we had to then, you know, we then get another free kick, and this time we spot on play, and I think we maybe put 20, 25 passes together. We get two or three waves of attacks, a couple of chances, and that gave us the confidence from there on in. And yeah, I thought we pressed brilliantly. I thought the energy from the top end of the pitch, Tom Hopper and Cameron McGeehan, incredible, incredible effort. And this allowed us to turn the ball over a lot. And probably, yeah, we had the fire, but now we just need to add the ice and just to get value for our hard work, really. But there was some really good individual performances. I thought Alistair Smith covered every blade of grass. If there's a blade of grass that he didn't cover, then I don't know where it is, because he was just everywhere. Riley Harbottle, without a background of games, to play with a fight that he did, and he's really going to add to our group. He's going to add a real physicality and a competitiveness, which I think will help everybody. And Jaden Reid, I thought his best game in Colchester United colours. And yeah, you know, you then add to that Jaden Fevrio, who I just thought gave their right back such a tough time all afternoon. There was some good individual performances. We're most pleased with the team performance, though. And yeah, obviously, when the team does play well, then you normally find a way to win.
Yeah, and of course, it isn't just the 11 that you start with. You know, you made all the changes you could make, and they all had an impact and kind of made sure we got over the line at 1-0.
Yeah, I always judge my team by the bench, and I can always tell when we've got a good team, because I call it always like a sexy bench. Like, you kind of, you know, it's a sexy, because you keep looking over your shoulder thinking, oh, I've got all these solutions, which is such a nice feeling for Nicky and I. And I said to the players before, you know, the boys that start the game, yeah, they play normally for the longer part of the game, but the boys that finish the game actually come on at the most important time in the game. So everyone's as equally as important as each other. And no matter if you start or finish, we need your contribution. And yeah, I thought the boys that come on did great. You know, Harry Anderson in particular come on and gave us such energy and such enthusiasm. He's going to be such a great signing for us. And you know, he's only been in the building 24 hours, but I think he's made an impact with everybody, which is the type of boy he is.
And a couple of days left of the transfer window, is it a case of hoping that no one goes? And of course, that, you know, any thoughts to get anyone else in?
Well, I think we've done some brilliant work. So, you know, I have to credit Dimitri and Ross Embleton, who have just been so supportive. January is never an easy window when you have maybe 4 or 5 months to prepare. Well, when new managers come in the window and everything changes, sometimes the profile of players that you're looking at change. You have to do an incredible amount of work in a really short space of time, and they've worked so diligently, and obviously Robbie has supported us so well. And you know, we're now in a position, yeah, thus far we've only signed some loan players, but these are all these are players that potentially we can sign permanently down the line. And sometimes you have to start a relationship somewhere. And I love these loans, especially the boys that have a little bit more experience, play games at the level, and that there's a potential to maybe extend the relationship for further down the line. So I think we've done some astute work. I thought we looked like a competitive League Two team today. I can feel a connection growing. I can feel a connection with the players growing off the pitch. And when it grows off the pitch, then it normally transcends on the pitch. And I can also feel a connection growing with the team and the supporters. And this, you know, I thought they were incredible today. Wow. For that many to travel that far on a cold January Saturday afternoon, just unbelievable. And we're so pleased that we were able to send them on their journey home with 3 points.